NASA found other ways of accessing the EBC server after last year's August election due to the EBC's refusal to open them. Rari Ida MP Oshindimolo said this at Parliament on Wednesday, sparking conversations about what hacking means and whether this is what happened. Those of us who belong to the NASA coalition complained in the Supreme Court, which directed that servers be opened, but the commission refused. We were able to access the servers and we published results, he said. On January 30, the EBC refuted NASA's claims that Raila Odinga won that presidential election, saying the opposition's allegations were false and meant to disgruntle Kenyans. The coalition had presented a report on the results through which they said Raila's January 30 swearing-in would be based. The report showed he got 8.1 million votes compared to President Uhuru Kenyatta's 7.9 million. Amolo had been giving his comments during heated debate on the cybersecurity bill. He said the bill does not pass the test as it creates immense confusion as to what national security is. If this bill was a law, we would now be serving jail terms of not less than 5 years, or we would be compelled to pay hefty fines, he said, adding it is heavy on penalties for 17 offenses. The MP noted jail terms can be of at least 3 years and at most 25, with fines going up to SH 25 million. This is the heaviest penalty in any legislation, Madam Speaker, Beatrice Ilachi. It does not exist anywhere. Creating severe penalties is not deterring people from offenses. People will only circumvent. Criminal jurisdiction suggests creation of rational offenses, ones that are not outrageous, he said. Amolo further said the bill does not define what national security is, thus qualifies anything to be rated as such. Regarding child pornography, he said the proposal has a strange exclusion in Section 13(2) where it established intentions for bona fide scientific research. What bona fide scientific research can there be in child pornography? This is a bizarre. In regards to cyber-stalking, the bill is also very unclear. Moranga woman Representative Sabina Chij, standing on a point of order, demanded that Amolo withdraw the statement alleging the opposition hacked EBC servers. Chij noted the sentiments can be put on record and used against the MP. It should be put on record that the MP presents evidence that they hacked the servers or withdraws the statement, she said. If they accessed the servers, that is hacking, so they must be held criminally liable. This bill has come in time, we must act or the MP must apologize. Her sentiments were echoed by Wambugun Gunjiri, Nairi Town, who demanded to know the meaning of hacking. Ngunjiri said NASA MPs should be tasked with telling Kenyans how they accessed the servers. If they claim this is not hacking, they should define what hacking is so that we all understand what they did, he said. But Makueni lawmaker Daniel Manzo defended Amolo, saying there was nothing criminal in what NASA did. Manzo noted that by that time, the law that criminalizes such activities was not in place. Hacking is not a crime as such as long as you do it for the common good of the people. Amolo has not done anything wrong. When you speak the truth and it is justifiable, there is no case against it. The bill will be presented for a second reading after the amendments that the MPs presented.